today in this class we discuss about the pivot table. We have just finished the home menu bar and move on the insert menu bar. In the insert menu bar we discuss about the pivot table. So first know about the pivot table. What is the pivot table? Pivot table used for the analyze the data, summarize the data and represent of the data. With pivot table you can create the summary of the data, you can analyze your data and create the report of the data with pivot table. So before starting using the pivot table, check your data. So before starting the using the pivot table, first check your data and understand your data. This is the IT help desk data. Say if we have a problem in the PC, raise the tickets and IT team solve the tickets. This is the data for the IT team data. So just summary of the how many tickets as per departments, which departments how many ticket range. So for that we have using the pivot table, insert menu bar, pivot table and okay. See here. So when you select the pivot table and just click the okay. After that insert the new sheets. And here is your pivot table report area menu. Click on this area. See here your pivot table navigation. And first is the field. This field belong to your data. Your data field show here. Just put the field and drop the these boxes. And when you drop these boxes, your field, your report will be generated here. Just like I want to departure wise total number of count of the your tickets. So click on the department and hold the click and move to row section. When you put the row sections, your all department list here. Note here, in the your data, every department repeated many times, but in the pivot table only for one time. So because this is the summary. So when you put the department on the row level, you can see the your list of the department row by. And if you put the department on the column level, you have see here your department as a column by. But I want to report row by, so click the row by and T number, put the values and automatically here count of the numbers. Okay, and this is the total number of, you can see here this is the repeated time because my data is the exact. So then I have repeat some data here and after that we have refresh here. You can change here, some department will be changed here. And this is your reports, but I want to modify my report. Just like there is the row level, but I want to enter here the departments. So we have manually change here. Yes, you can manually change here. How can manually change? Just type here. It's like department and press the enter. Also total tickets. You can also change here, but you can't change the total. Which field have calculated in the values, you can't change here. If you try to change, you can't change here. Mr. Krishna, it is clear?
Yeah. If you want to change, you should change from the master sheet.
when you change your master sheet original data, pivot table not affected. When you rephrase your pivot table, then your changes will be affected here.
Yeah.
Okay. Okay. Next, you can also format your data. You can also apply the normal formatting here, just like border, and background color, foreground color, everything. It's like normal data you have formatted. But some problem here, when you refresh the pivot table, your format may be unchanged. Because you have applied the pivot, your formatting here till 12, but when you refresh your data, maybe data will change or your pivot table increase the value of your data. So formatting can't increase because formatting not linked with the pivot table. That time we use the predefined pivot table. Click on the predefined pivot table format. Click on the pivot table. Go to the design menu bar. In the design menu bar have a lot of pre-formatted style here. You can select light, medium, dark. Which you want to apply, just click and you can apply the format. And this format connected with your pivot table. When you change your pivot table, your format will also increase and decrease because this format connected with your pivot table. You can also apply the pivot chart here. Just like I want to visualize with chart, that time go to the pivot table, analyze here. There is the pivot table chart. Click on the pivot table chart and select your chart. You can also apply the normal chart. It's not a necessary key if you want to apply chart on pivot table, so use the pivot chart here. You can also apply the normal chart. Automatically this chart connected with the pivot table. Just like we have created chart here. And my chart connected with pivot table. When you change my pivot table, just like I have dropped the department to city. You can see here your pivot table changed, your formatting also changed. All your data will be also changed. So this is the normal pivot table style. So next I want to apply the pivot table, but not a single. I want to double twice. Just like I want to which person, which department, how many, what is the average customer rate. Okay. So I want to report which persons, which department, how many customer, what is the average of the customer rate. So just select the pivot table, select the data and click on the pivot table, insert the new sheet, and there is the pivot table navigation. So we have applied here the department, the customers, and there is the customer rate. So when you put the customer rate, automatically here is the sum, but I want to the average. So just click on here and select the pivot table value field static, and you have changed your sum to average. So here are options. You can sum, count, average, minimum, maximum, product, everything on your data. So select on the average and okay, there is the average. But this is the not correct format, so you can change your format. Select and go to the home, and this is the, you can also apply here the number, and here the zero decimal places, and okay. And you can also select the all sheet and just double click on the column width, and this is the automatically auto fill. This is the my report. So my report is the matrix format. Okay, this is the matrix format. But one problem in this format, if you have a small list of the your legend, you can put here, just like we have put the name here. So we have the small list of the name, but if you have the long size of your list, that time we have get the problem. I give you the one, another example for that. Yeah, right. Wait a few minutes. Yeah, right. We have this data. I have created the pivot table. And OK. So we have select the, they give the total quantity of sale. I want to city wise report, but when you put the city on the column, my city list is the large list of the, my city. So we have problem with the navigate because this is the left to right, but you can't print a one page, have a problem. You can not, you have problem in the navigate, not view on the single windows. So that type of the problem in the, if you have horizontally data. But if you have the vertical data, you can also scroll here. How can you give the vertical? So put the city on the secondary row. Yeah, now secondary row, you can see here, appellated, you can see the city. You can also switch, it's like your city is a property. So put on the first on the city. So this is a city wise report. And every city have a symbol, that's that called collapse and expand. When you click, your city will be collapsed, and when you again click, you expand. You have click the single time, every expand and collapse, go to the pivot table analyze, there is the plus symbol. When you click here, expand all of your list, and when you click the minus and collapse or all of the list. This is the summary of the summary. This is the summary of the summary. But this report, only for the in pivot, but in the office we have copy, apply the, make the pivots and copy and paste to another files and add the some alag the different calculations and different thing in the your reports. So pivot table, use the pivot table, just look supporting your report, not a only pivot reports. That time if you have, just like expand here, I have copy and paste to another location, just like paste as a value, remove the pivot. Now we have problem. I can't understand what is the Delhi, what is the city, and what is the your sales mode, because both of the filled in the one column. So I want to different column. I want to first column have a city, and second column the sales mode, and third is the quantity. That time we have the two way. First, go to the design tab and report layout, and second the outline form or and also tabular form, both are the same format. And you can also right click on the pivot table, go to the options, and here is the display and classical pivot table layout, and you can got the result here. So first column A is the city, second is the sales mode, and you can see here, after your city, every city have a grand total, the subtotal, sorry, subtotal. So do you want to remove this type of the subtotal? Just right click and remove subtotal. Every city subtotal will be removed. Now we have also problem, because where is the copy and paste on the location, I can't apply the filter because this is the blank area. So I want to fill, not show the blank row, I want to fill with the city, just like Patna, Udaipur. How many times it was blank, you have filled the your city here. That time we have go to the design tab. This is the repeat all item label. Click on the repeat all item label, you can see here your item will be repeated. You can also apply the blank row. When you apply the insert blank row, here is the blank. Go to the blank, remove blank. You can also do not repeat item level. Now I want to merge your blank cell. There is a merge. That time we can't apply the directory merge. You can select here, you can't apply the merge. See here. time we have select the pivot table options, merge and center with sales label, and OK. You can see here, your data will be merged here. OK, Mr. Krishnan?
Yeah, clear, clear.
So this is the pivot table part one. Now, next question, next pivot table discussion is just like pivot table calculation, sorting, filter, moving on the pivot table, calculation the pivot table, like that. But pivot table is a very important topic. So I suggest you keep learn slowly and do more and more practice. Because if you have command of the pivot table, you can create the your 60 to 80% report in the office. Okay. It is a possible you can create the your 60 to 80% report with pivot table. So this is a very important, and if you have command on the pivot table, we have also learned the Power BI and Tableau, because Power BI and Tableau just based on the pivot table. Okay, Mr. Krishnan?
Yeah,